Hello, ladies and gentlemen, Blank Check here, and today, an update video. Been a while since my last one, and obviously this is a special occasion given what's happened in the past month. My last video was a pretty significant one, but we'll get to that in a little while because this is a multifaceted update. I have three distinct topics. The first one is about the Discord server, which has been going strong for half a year now? Really? Wow. The server's definitely gone through changes since the launch back in March. Events like game nights and movie nights, new features that I'm not totally up to date on, but my staff has been pushing them out. And I'll take a moment here to announce a new event. It's a Discord Community Showcase. It's a contest slash challenge for server members, which includes various prizes that I'll get to in a second. It's an idea we've been tinkering with, and if it goes well, we will do more in the future. So let's get to it, because the first Community Showcase challenge is to design a banner for the Discord server. The rules are it can be any kind of artwork as long as it is MLP related or related to me. It does not necessarily have to focus on or even include me, but we are asking for no other OCs in the art. And there's obviously some discretion here on what the staff is willing to accept. You know, keep it clean enough. The due date is November 27th, that is right before Thanksgiving for us Americans. And the winner or winners, there can be more than one in this one. As I mentioned, get a number of prizes. The first is a special showcase winner role and tag on the server. You'll get a shoutout from me here on YouTube or on social media like Twitter or DeviantArt, plus an entry into a gift card giveaway. Also, because this is a banner design contest, your art will be used as the banner for the server for some period of time, depending on the number of winners and other factors. But beyond that, not just for winners, but for every eligible entry, I will be putting together a video showcase, putting on display all the awesome work you guys do after we decide the winners. It's just one of many things that the staff has been putting up or changing about the server over the past several months. With the show being over, we'll get to that in a minute here as well, they've wanted to make this a great place for people to talk about MLP and hang out with other fans while we wait for G5, as well as the G4 comics that I think are coming out next year. I really appreciate the work they've done, and I appreciate those of you in the server who are making this a community. That's one topic done. Topic two is more brief. Ponyville Ciderfest is very close. It's under a week away, so I don't expect to sway anyone into going, but I wanted to mention that I will be there in Milwaukee in the Hyatt Regency. It is the first PonyCon since the end of the show, so it feels like kind of a big deal. Kind of a bittersweet event to celebrate and remember the show. And based on my experience last year, it's a great time. Less crowded, less busy, more personal than BronyCon. They have guests including the voices of Sweetie Belle, Starlight, Cozy Glow, and Yona, Big Jim, Andy Price, the comic artist, and storyboard artists, as well as from the community, the Bronies React guys, a lot of the anthology team, Argo Damon, Minty Root, a bunch of artists, Scope, hello Mr. Horse Famous, if anyone's watching this, it's you. So yeah, just wanted to point out to anyone going, I will be there and feel free to say hey, I don't bite much. See, quick and painless. Topic 3, less quick and less painless. So, I don't know if you've noticed, but the show is over. The channel's not over though, don't worry about that. Right now I'm just taking a short break after the crazy week of editing after that three-part finale. For the near future, I'm treating this like another mid-season hiatus. I'll be tackling community videos, both newer ones, upcoming like Remembrance and maybe the Bronies React to the finale or in-progress animations, as well as things that have slipped by me in the recent or distant past. In addition, I believe I have to catch up on some Equestria Girls content. Things might be a little sparse for the next month or so, because I have a lot of travel scheduled, personal like Ciderfest, but also work trips. Starting last week, actually, I'm looking to be a lot busier at work than before, but hopefully that does not affect my energy or my free time too much. Now, long term is honestly not clear. The two things I'm bad at are long term plans and decision making. Gen 5 is definitely something I have sights on and I'm interested in what it is, but that's a ways off. I built my channel on the back of MLP and its community. And this is a real special niche where I've had support from both fans and content creators, on top of leniency from Hasbro itself. And that's a perfect storm that's very hard to come by. I feel like I've had the privilege to find a level of legitimacy that an average person doesn't associate with reaction channels, largely because this community is so welcoming. I don't want to lose that, you know? I don't want to feel dirty making videos. Like, there's a reason I've never monetized one of them. And the fact is, no matter what I do, only a subset of you will be interested, because everyone signed on for one topic, MLP. That is a fact, one I've always been aware of, but has been emphasized ever since the end was announced. It's unfortunate for sure, but this is a hobby for me. I imagine I'd be more broken up if I actually made money from it. Whatever I do, another show, video games, something more scripted, it would all be a fundamental shift. To throw even more on top of this, next year I'd like to jump back on track for my master's degree, because my thesis project didn't really pan out before I got my job, so I'd be going back to classes and those would be juggled outside of my full-time job. Suffice to say, there's a lot to think about, and I'm sorry to report that I don't have the answers right now. At the moment, I'm not counting anything out. There are a lot of options up for grabs. My plans are short-term, and winging it is my, well, not specialty, but I tend to do it a lot. So, ladies and gentlemen, that was a bit of a non-update update, but thank you for taking the time to listen. Hopefully, I will work something out. Until then, I will see some of you at Ciderfest, and everyone else, I hope you have a wonderful nightmare night.